Today I will talk about assignment operators in C programming. In last video I talked about logical operators in C. What is the importance of the logical operators in C? We had a discussion in last video. But what is the use of the assignment operator in C? The assignment operator is very important operator in C programming, because assignment operator is used to assign a value to a particular variable. Because here, what is the assignment? Equal symbol. Here the most common assignment operator is what? This one. Okay, the equal symbol is called as the assignment operator. In mathematics we call it as equal, but here in the programming language we call it as what? Assignment operator. Because if, for example, x equal to 5, what is here? The x is nothing but a variable. Okay, then y is what? This is nothing but what? Assignment operator. Okay, then here assignment operator is used to assign a value to a variable, because x is a variable. 5 is assigned to the what? Variable x. What is meaning of this statement? X value is what? Then 5. Okay, here to assign a value to a particular variable with help of the what? Assignment operator. Okay, suppose another one is int. Suppose y equal to 10. Because here the y is nothing but what? Variable. Here 10 is the value, because value is 10 is assigned to the what? Variable y. Because y is nothing but what? Variable. Then this is value should be assigned to the variable y. This is also called a simple assignment operator. Okay, there are two types of the here this type of expressions are called as the simple assignment operator. These equal symbol, if you want to assign a particular value to a variable, we should done it with help of the assignment operator. Here there are two types of the assignment operator. There are two types of assignment operator. Assignment operators. The first one is simple assignment. Second one is compound assignment. Here, what is the difference between the simple assignment and compound assignment? Okay, the simple assignment expressions are, for example, suppose x equal to y plus 1. Suppose x equal to x plus 1. Okay, then x equal to 5. Then y equal to x plus 1. Because, first of all, you know that whenever using the assignment operator, how do you evaluate this expression? Because you look at here, suppose y equal to x plus 1. But x plus y equal to 5. What is the difference between these two? Which one is correct? It is correct, but it is not correct. Why? Listen carefully. Here, the left side of the assignment operator should be a only one operand. Here, how many operands are there? Two, but it is not correct. Whenever using the assignment operator, okay, the left side of the assignment operator should be only one operand. Okay, notice that left side of assignment operator should be a only one operand or variable. Because the x plus y equal to 5, it is correct in mathematics, but it is not correct in the programming language. Because left side of the assignment operator should be only 1.
The right side of the assignment operator should be expression. It may contains more than one operands, which involves more than one variable also. But the left side of the assignment operator should be only one operand. That is very, very important. But it is correct, but it is not. Both are correct in mathematics, but it is not correct in the programming, but it is correct in the program. Because in the right side of the assignment operator should be an expression. Okay, because to evaluate the expression, on right side of the assignment operator, okay, then that value should be stored in the variable on the left side of the assignment operator. Okay, again I am telling you, to evaluate the expression on right side of the assignment operator, and the result will be stored in the variable on left side of the assignment operator. That is very, very important. Here you can write any one, x equal to x plus 1, y plus 1 equal to, suppose, y plus z equal to 5. It is also not correct. Okay, but because the left side of the assignment operator should be only two operands, because it is not correct. It is correct, because left side of the assignment operator only should be one operand. Okay, keep it in your mind, the left side of the assignment operator should be only one operand. That is very, very important. Hope it is clear. Yeah. Then here this type of expressions are called the simple assignment expression. What about the compound assignment expression? There are five types of the compound assignment expression. Here, for example, plus equal, minus equal, multiplication equal, then division equal, then modulus equal. These are called as what? Compound assignment operator. Here just plus equal is common. Plus equal, minus equal, multiplication equal, then division equal, modulus equal. Okay, this type of expressions are called as the compound assignment expression. Here these expressions are called as what? Simple assignment. Okay, whenever the compound assignment expression has given, what should you do? Then it should be converted into the simple assignment. Okay. Suppose this is a compound assignment. Okay, how do you do compound assignment expression? Because simple assignment, how should be converted to the simple assignment is very important. Because the plus equal, x plus equal. Because x is the operand, y is the operand. Because what is the equivalent of this one is x equal to x plus y. Then x minus equal to y. X equal to x minus y, because then x multiplication equal to y. What is the equivalent statement is x multiplication with y. Then x division y equal to y is x equal to x divided by y. Then x modulus operator equal to y. Then x equal to x modulus operator equal to y. Because if you write the x plus y, what is the meaning of x equal x plus? To evaluate that expression, again the resultant will be, the result will be stored in the variable x. Because for example, x value is 5, then y value is 2. Here the x value is 2. So for example, x value is 5, then y value is 2. Okay, y value becomes 2. X plus y. Just x equal to x plus. What is the x value is 5 plus 2. Again the result will be stored in the variable x, 7. The previous is what? X value is 5. Then now what is the x value? X value becomes 7. Then x minus equal to y. The x equal to x minus y. What is the x value is now? You can see here. Then 7 minus y is what? 2. Then what is the x value is now? Again it value becomes 5. Then x multiplication equal to y. The x equal to xy. What is the x value is here? You change, you can take the modified value. Then 5 into 2. What is the value? 10. Okay, x value is what? 10. X divided, then x divide operator equal to y. X equal to x divided by y. What is the x value is? 10. What is the y value is? 2. what will be stored in the x value, you should consider what is quotient, not remainder. Okay, what is the quotient is 5 again. Okay, 2 5 is 10. Back again, x modulus equal to y. X equal to x modulus operator. Why? This is called as modulus operator. Okay, don't confuse. Modulus operator. Then what is the value of now? Then 5, then 2. What is the remainder? Remainder is what? 1. Finally, if you display the x value and y value, the x value becomes 1. The y value remains same. The y value does not change because again the result will be stored in the variable x only. Okay, x plus equal to y. Then you should convert into the simple assignment expression. The x equal to x plus y. Then how the result will be stored in the variable x. Because you don't consider the previous initial value x. Okay, every time the x value will be changed. Okay, then you can take the only changed value. Okay, don't take the initial value for the evaluating the expression. Even if you compile it, then same output will be displayed by the compilers. Okay, here these are called as what? Compound assignment expression. Don't confuse. Okay, x plus y equal to what? X equal to x plus y. X minus equal to what? X equal to x minus y. That is the way to convert into the simple assignment expression. After that, to evaluate the expression. Okay, then I will write the example for the assignment operator. Here we should call assignment operator. Don't call the equal symbol in the programming. Okay, in case of interview also, whenever attend, we can call it the what? Assignment operator. Don't call the what? Equal symbol. Generally we call it equal, but original meaning is that assignment operator. Don't call the equal symbol. Okay, equal, this is called as equal. It is not an equal, it is called as what? Assignment operator. Then simply I will write the example for it. Ash include stdio.h. Then void main, because some of the compiler does not support the void. At that time you can use the int. Okay, suppose int x y printf enter x and y value, x and y values. Because you have to take these values during the runtime, then scanf, then percentile d, then x, y. Okay? Then you have to read the x value and y value. Then you should write printf. Addition equal to, then I am writing directly here, you should write the percentile d, then x plus equal to y, then printf subtraction equal to, then percentile d comma x minus equal to y. Then you compile this program, you can check it what is the answer is displaying by the compiler. Okay, then x multiplication equal to y, then printf what is called division equal to, sorry to say, you should write percentile d, otherwise you should not get any output. X divide equal to y, then print of what is called modulus r, modulus operator equal to r remainder, and you can write like this also. X remain modulus operator. Yeah. Then
If you compile this one, if you take the what is called x sum, you can take some h value. Okay, h value is 5, 10, then y value is 5. Then what is the x value or y value taken? X value becomes 1, 10. What is the y value? Y value becomes, then what is the expression value? Then you should look at what is the output of these programs. What is the output of this statement? Addition equal to, subtraction equal to, multiplication equal to, division equal, then modulus of. Then you can, because you can evaluate these, sorry to say, then you can scan all the statements and you can expect what is the output you are going to get for this statement, this statement, and this statement, and this statement, and last statement, and you compare. Your expected output is correct or not. Then after that you can compile this program. Then you, whether it is displayed, the compiler is displayed by the same output or not. Okay, then you both are matching, then whatever output you are expected, that is correct. Because most of the students simply search in the Google and copy the code and execute it. Don't do that, because a number of solution will be there to a single problem. Okay, you can implement a number of ways for the same problem. That's why we can do it by one. Okay, how to do it? You can think logically, then you can improve the programming skills. Hope it is clear, because if you want any kind of program, I will write it. Okay, just you post your program in the comment box window, then I will write the program and send it to you. Okay, today I talked about what is the importance of assignment operator in programming language. Thank you one and all. Thank you for watching my video.